Well, he had a good time. Now he could do time. This Wells Fargo customer went to sleep with $35 in his account, and when he woke up, nearly $70,000. So you know what he did? He went on a spending spree. He bought a dog, a car, a trip to Florida, and more. Now, well, he's facing felony charges and possibly a 14-year jail sentence. But did he break the law? Let's ask defense attorney Meg Strickler. Meg, I got to tell you, I'm not sure there's very many people out there who wouldn't have done the same thing. Maybe not to the extent that he did it. He had a great time. But what law did he break?
He broke the law because there was money put in his account by accident, and he needed to have returned it. It's called theft by receiving. He received stolen property and converted it for his own use. So technically he broke the law, but I bet you there's not a jury out there who's like, good job, go peeve off the banks that peeved us off for all these past few years, all the things they've done to us, all these failed banks. I don't think a jury would convict him. I would hope that somehow this case will get resolved long before it gets there.
You know, I got to tell you, maybe I remember it wrong, but years ago, Roberto Duran got like a $4 million check from the IRS. They didn't put him in jail, but I tell you what, his next fight, they were the first ones in after the fight was over. First they came in and then a promoter came in. Isn't there some way they can let this guy work this off? Because if you put him in jail, no one's ever going to see this money again.
No, honestly, I would hope that this case, even though he had to turn himself into Ben Salem PA police today, they will ultimately find a way to lessen the charges so that he's not even convicted. I would hope. But yes, I mean, he would probably get a conviction of just felony probation and get a few years probation. This isn't the crime of the century. He didn't do anything wrong other than got a great amount of money and said, woohoo, versus what he should have done is gone to Vegas maybe and spend some of that way, place a bet, and then all maybe the things he gained from that, he wouldn't have had to give that back.
Hopefully
there'll be no restitution here.
If he'd have played a game of poker and won another 70 grand, he could have kept that 70?
Technically, if no one knew about it, yeah,
oh, okay.
He would only have to give back what the bank gave him, the $69,000 here.
How often do these kind of things happen? Because, you know, that's... like I said at the top of the show, top of this piece here, a lot of people watching this would have did the same thing.
This has happened a few times. If you Google this, actually, there was a guy who got $8 million. It happens often with $15,000, $1,500. When the extra zero is put in by accident, or the teller might give you, instead of $60, you're cashing a check, she'll give you $600. This happens very, very often. But what is interesting here is most people say, hey, bank teller, you made a mistake.
Right.
Y'all put some money in my account. You shouldn't have. What's funny here is that, ironic here is he spent it.
Meg, if it was me, I would use a tooth fairy. I would say the tooth fairy left it. Thanks a lot. We appreciate it.
Sure.
All right. Next, the CEO behind a controversial marketing campaign that's offering free pizza, but only for Spanish speakers.